Greetings to all. We like to express a hearty welcome to our YouTube channel once again. Throughout the four seasons of Netflix's 13 Reasons Why, a group of high school students with significant ups and downs, the contentious series has dealt with difficult issues that have drawn both outrage and appreciation from fans. Today, we'll discuss why 13 Reasons Why is the most loved and hated show ever. Most loved show ever. Number 10. Alex. We can see that Alex arrived at school and immediately made friends with Hannah and Jessica. And while there was usual high school drama going on, he took too much to heart and became a tragedy, attempted tragedy. Despite the fact that he was ultimately guilty of Bryce's death, he was redeemed in a beautiful way. He came to grips with his sexuality, something he hadn't really grasped until this moment, and began to recognize that he deserved life and forgiveness. He eventually understood that he wanted to enjoy life to the fullest. Number 9. Jessica converted her pain into an experience. The most wonderful part is where Jessica converted her sadness into an experience that would assist others and give women a voice after turning from a popular local ugly girl to a sensitive young woman who was attacked and whose boyfriend at the time enabled it to happen. She rose to the position of the school president, spoke up on important topics, and established herself as a leader who was respected by everybody. She was stern and frightening at times, to be sure. She, on the other hand, had earned the right to be herself. And even though she was still in pain, she discovered a method to deal that allowed her to show people that she was a genuine survivor. Number 8. Justin's sudden death. While many fans were outraged by Justin's sudden death in the final season, claiming that the show portrayed HIV/AIDS as a death sentence at a time when it most certainly isn't, his storyline leading up to his sickness was one of the greatest. But eventually, it was revealed that he had been having a difficult life with a medication addict mother as a pretentious high school idol and athlete. After declining to stay with Bryce, he became homeless and addicted to medication. However, once Clay's parents signed for guardianship and sent him to rehab, he appeared to have the family life he deserved as well as a college future. While viewers wanted to see him totally forgiven and cured, the sickness was essential to demonstrate that life does not always have a happy ending. Number 7. Alex Standall. Everything Alex does wrong is a tiny act, still terrible, don't get worked up, that contributes to a bigger evil. In a fit of rage, he added Hannah's name to the list. He assumed it was a desperate harlot hooking up with Bryce, not realizing it was Hannah who was being violated. But he has a wonderful heart. Apart from Assis Baker, there is arguably no more regretful figure on the program. He destroyed himself because he was so guilty. And after he's recovered, all he wants to do is support Jessica. Not because he wants to possess her as Clay as Hannah, but because it's the proper thing to do. Number 6. Strongest Girl Jessica Davis. This character is the most powerful, nicest, and underappreciated. Season 2 feels like it's all about her, and we're ready for it. Jessica's video, which serves as her explanation for why she's partly to blame for Hannah's murder, tells the narrative of how miscommunication and misunderstanding ruin a friendship. Now that she's back in school, she has to put up with everyone's nonsense, including Clay's, Justin's, and Chloe's. She gracefully navigates one of the most difficult situations imaginable, and she really wants to improve things for her classmates. Jess, you'll never change. Most hated show ever. Number 5. ICE deported the family of a supporting character. Season 3's goal is to give each character a possible motivation for brutalizing Bryce Walker. Wouldn't it have been better if Bryce simply wrecked Tony's car? Instead, Tony's parents are deported by Bryce's evil father. It's only given one episode of focus, like the other season 3 plotlines, so it feels cheaply inserted, part of the show's tendency to confuse trauma with character development. Character trauma for the sake of adding more ripped from the headlines, plotting to a show feels exploitative and cruel. The show also seems ready to get rid of their parents' roles. It's not only 13 Reasons Why. TV writers often feel constrained when portraying teens who live like teenagers, and one of the simplest ways to get around this is to make them fabulously affluent or parentless. But we can see that only Clay, Bryce, and Tyler's parents appear more than once by the third season. Tony's actor, Christian Navarro, is in his late 30s, which doesn't help matters. They might have easily discovered methods for him to be more self-sufficient without being spectacular. Number 4. Instigated the first riot of a baby. As we know, Season 2 couldn't have been expected to be published the day after a school shooting, and Season 4 couldn't have been predicted to be released amid worldwide rallies against white supremacy and police brutality. but sadly, it did. And while a worldwide conversation about the subject arose that was mainly intellectual and important, 13 reasons why failed to meet the challenge. The racial undertones that precede the riot are thrown in for the purpose of stating they're there, with no meaningful debate or analysis, just as they are with other topics. The cop who hits Diego, who is Latinx, and ignores Justin for the exact same fight is the incident that starts the riot. And Jessica does mention later that the students singled out by riot police. Yes, riot police were largely students of color. No one, however, mentions that the school's police state disproportionately affects pupils of color, such as Tommy, and no one dares to remark that the two most dangerous students, Alex and Tyler, are white. When Jess, a passionate and educated woman of color, leads the riot, she never once mentions the school's discriminatory practices while holding the megaphone. Number 3. With 2 weekly treatment sessions, a character's serious mental difficulties were resolved. We can see that Clay Jensen has been his own greatest adversary throughout seasons 1 and 2. Clay wasn't really unbearable until season 3, when he was wrongfully convicted of a crime and the entire world was out to get him. Otherwise, Clay has always been the root of most of Clay's issues. Whether it's his self-righteousness, unwillingness to listen to others, feeling of victimization, or general martyrdom inclinations, Clay, on the other hand, has a real reason this season. Clay is now his own greatest enemy as a result of his trauma. He has developed some type of dissociative personality disorder. We learn at the conclusion of the season that all of Clay's bad luck is the result of an alternate Clay. But sadly, Clay's alternate personality is an all-out violent psychopath who smirks as he terrorizes his pals, and it not only continues the long history of all media condemning persons with personality disorders, but it also oversimplifies Clay's rehabilitation. Let it be known that Clay is in such a vulnerable position that he takes a cop's pistol, terrifies his buddies with an axe, smashes security cameras, flips a car while driving intoxicated, and then tries to rob a police station. He's never been jailed, admitted to his psychiatric facility, he is, but he sneaks out and suffers no repercussions or discussed medicine, and he doesn't appear to miss school. Number 2. Police and authoritarians are extremely nice and helpful. Although 13 Reasons Why has a lot of unlikable characters, most of them are salvageable by virtue of their kindness, humor, or chemistry with other characters. Sheriff Diaz, on the other hand, is nothing but nasty, unyielding, and hostile during his 2 seasons on the show. And well, it's a good fit. He is a police officer. But he receives one of the most undeserved ends in the series, which is saying a lot given that virtually everyone gets an undeserved conclusion. He hugs a weeping Clay, who had just attempted to hold up the station, calms him down, and lets him go without being charged. Clay even admits that he understands that all of the checking in, harassment, and cagey hostility is because he cares. What a lovely gesture. The show's authors had no clue it would premiere this season in the middle of a backlash against white supremacy and police brutality, as we mentioned under the riot issue. But given that the show has always claimed to be on top of social issues, couldn't it see how tone-deaf it is to show Lily White Clay getting away with things that a black or brown kid would have been shot for, and to end the season with Sheriff Diaz hugging Clay's violence away like a toddler throwing a tantrum? On the other hand, Alexi's father, too, is just concerned. He loves enough about his kid to overlook important details in the Bryce Walker case in order to safeguard his son's innocence. Oh, and Diaz is fine with it at the end of the day. Number 1. Feminist activists are portrayed in an outdated and disrespectful manner. 13 Reasons Why began with overt feminist messages, but by the 3rd season, it had effectively undone them. Jessica creates an activist organization to combat the abuse culture in college after her attack. The group, on the other hand, becomes a walking personification of the ridiculous question, has the hashtag MeToo movement gone too far? They're also presented as being bad for opposing Bryce's burial, despite the fact that they seem to be the only ones who recall that Bryce was a terrible pervert throughout the season. That is it for today. Let us know in the comments below if you enjoy this video. Do like, share, and subscribe to our channel. For more updates from us, click on the bell icon to get a notification. See you next time.